to my business card.
In Westerville, Ohio, that is lawyer Emmanuel Oluwole. On his own law office property, he is dumping out trash.
Okay. All right.
ID? Huh? Let me show you my ID.
If you don't mind, just so... Yeah, if you don't mind, can we see your ID?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Well, that is pretty cool.
That's a slick business card.
Yep.
All right. I'll give it to him. You can keep doing what you're doing. We're just... Again, we were kind of concerned. Yeah. Seeing somebody dump a bunch of stuff there. Mm-hmm. So...
Okay. Yeah.
Right. Just don't run it. Don't run my card. Don't run my ID.
Huh?
Don't run my ID.
Don't run your ID?
I have no reason to.
He is right.
Well, we're going to at least mark it down. We're going to take down your information.
Nope. I'm on my property putting trash in mine.
Okay. But this is, this is not just your property. It's several people's property.
I understand.
Okay.
But I'm not violating any law. So don't
no
run
one
my
said
ID.
That you're violating any
no,
law.
No. Don't run my ID. I'm a lawyer. I know my rights.
Okay.
I'm not violating any law. I'm on my property. There's no suspicion. No one called anybody. So don't run my ID. I only identify myself so that this won't escalate.
That's fine. But we can still mark down who we're out with. And so that's what we're going to do.
No.
Yes.
You didn't stop me. Don't turn this into an issue.
Sir, you are turning this into an issue. We're just simply marking down who we're out with.
Yeah.
So he's just going to write it down on a piece of paper.
It's just your name.
Why?
Because, sir, we are out with you because we were concerned that you were illegally dumping.
But you've already discovered. Do you want me to show you my office?
I understand that you're here, but I don't know if this dumpster belongs to you or somebody else in the
It belongs
complex.
To me.
To you and you alone?
Yes.
Can you prove that dumpster belongs to you and you alone?
No, he does not have to prove he owns the dumpster.
If it's also other units...
So what? It belongs to everybody. We're paying for it. It doesn't really matter if it belongs to all the unit.
That's fine.
Just give me back my ID. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. I'm David Shuster, and thanks for watching. Emmanuel Oluwole says he had no problem with the officers checking to see if there was illegal dumping. The problem came when they wanted to run his ID. With no suspicion, no call to police prompting this incident, taking his ID and checking to see what it may show is against settled case law. Now, you may think, well, if you don't have any criminal record or a suspended license, why object? Well, the law is the law, and police take an oath to abide by the Constitution. Relatedly, legal experts say there is generally nothing wrong with an officer writing down on a piece of paper the name of somebody they talk to. Maybe the police want to put it in a report or a memo. But taking your driver's license and running a check on it means you are detained and cannot leave. And when there's no probable cause for such a detention, it violates the Constitution. Oluwole believes he was the victim here of racial profiling, and it certainly seems that way. Why didn't the officers believe the word of this black man? They had his business card and a driver's license confirming he was who he said he was. His law office sign is on the building. This was a white man or a white lawyer. Would these cops have sought to run his driver's license? Oluwole got his business card and license back without police scanning or running it. However, when the cops got back in their cruiser, the body camera shows they did a background check anyway.
All right, just turn around, get out of here, and then look him up. You got to put some zippers. As are in my hands.
When the police looked him up, they confirmed again he was who he said he was, with no criminal record. The city of Westerville says it is now investigating the conduct of these two Ohio police officers. As we've seen time and again, police often misuse their power, especially against people of color. Thankfully, in this case, nobody got hurt, and the only long-term damage may be to the reputation of the Westerville Police Department.